the most innocent thing. Have you heard it?
Yeah, I have.
I thought you might have, because it has a lot to do with doing projects. But the reason I chose it today was because this morning when I woke up, I wasn't feeling so good about some things. And this book helped me. And I thought, wow, if it helped me, maybe it can help other people, because it's got some really good ideas in it. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to ask you if you ever do elbow. Do you ever do turn and talk or elbow buddies? Do you ever sit right next to someone who doesn't have a partner to talk to? Mm-hmm. Can you do that? Can you scoot right next to somebody near you? It'll help. You don't have to. You don't really like to do it, but it'll be useful to be sitting next to somebody. Okay? And then, thank you. Wow. That's good. And then the other thing I'd like to ask you to do is, when you're thinking about something, when I ask you a question, when you're thinking about it, can you all put your finger on your brain? Because that'll be a signal to me that you're thinking. And then if you come up with an idea, will you go like this? Got the idea. Because that way I'll know, are people still thinking? Because slow thinking is good sometimes. It's very useful to be a slow thinker. And then I'll know when people kind of are going around. Okay. So the first thing, is that good? Okay. Oh, there's one more thing. If you're turned and talking to each other, at some point I'm going to need you to stop talking to each other, even though I know you like to do that, because we're going to go on with the story. So when that happens, when I need your attention again, I'm going to go something like, and you're going to go and turn back to me. Okay, got it? Okay, so number one, let's see, what was number one? What was this thing about? Yep. What was this about when you're...
Thinking.
And then what do you do when you get your idea?
Bing!
God, yeah, but without the sound effects would be good. So down on sound effects, but think boing in your head, okay? That'd be perfect. And then if I need your attention, I'll go something like, and you'll go. Perfect. So first thing I want you to think about, this is a thinking on your own, so just thinking in your head. What are some other words for magnificent? The most magnificent thing? What does magnificent mean? What could it mean? Okay. Does it mean tasty? Or does it mean stinky? Or does it mean... So, who's got an idea? Who would like to share an idea? I see a lot of fingers up. Okay. Whoa, way back there. Yep.
Amazing
is a good one. Anybody have a different one than amazing? Yep.
Marvelous.
Brilliant.
Brilliant thing.
Yep. Back.
Awesome.
That was
your
idea. That happens. Yep. Yep.
Cool.
Cool. Yes.
I thought
mindful. That is an interesting word. Okay. So here we go. Thank you. You guys are great. I think we got it down. So. If you've heard it before, try to enjoy it anyway. I've read a lot of my favorite books more than one time. This is a regular girl and her best friend in the whole world. They do all kinds of things together. They race, they eat, they explore, they
play.
Relax. I like the relaxing part. She makes things and he unmakes things. One day the girl has a wonderful idea. She is going to make the most magnificent thing.
Invention.
Thing is, you know, invention is actually a better word than thing, isn't it? In this case. She knows just how it will look. She knows just how it will work. All she has to do is make it. And she makes things all the time. Easy peasy. First, she hires an assistant. The girl tinkers, next, they gather their supplies, they set up somewhere out of the way and get to work, yeah. So if you see where they are, maybe not so out of the way.
Yeah.
Like in their apartment.
She's a bit on the side, isn't she? Yeah. She's got a lot of stuff, but people are kind of stepping around her. The girl tinkers and hammers and measures while her assistant pounces and growls and chews. When she's finished, she steps back to admire her work. She walks around one side. Her assistant examines the other side.
It doesn't look right.
Her assistant picks it up and gives it a shake. Doesn't feel right either. They are shocked to discover the thing isn't magnificent. Or good. It isn't even any sort of okay. It is all wrong. The girl tosses it aside and gives it another go. And this is where I'd like you to turn and talk, because can you think of the last time you tried something and you had to try it more than once? The first time did not work at all. So if you could just tell your partner a time when you tried something, it would have been as simple as making a letter or as hard as a question. She's finished. She stands up and takes a good long look at it. Her assistant gives it a nudge with his paw. The thing is still wrong. She decides to try again. The girl saws and glues and adjusts. She stands and examines and stares. She twists and tweaks and fastens. She fixes and straightens and studies. She tries all kinds of ways to make it better. What is the word for that? Just think in your head by yourself. What's the word for when you try over and over again and you don't give up?
Try it.
Put your finger on your head if you're thinking. Put your finger on your head if you're thinking. And then put your finger up if you remember what that word is. What is that word? Everybody say a word that means you keep trying.
Perseverance.
Oh, this is awesome. Okay, great. She makes it square. She makes it round. She gives it legs. She gives it antenna. This girl is not just persistent and hardworking, and I also heard keep trying. She and perseverance, I think I heard somewhere. She also is flexible. She's trying all kinds of different things, and she's pretty creative. She makes it fuzzy, long, short, rough, smooth, big. One even smells of stinky cheese. But none of them are magnificent. You're getting kind of the audio version back there. I'm sorry. Should I hold it up for you so you can actually see? Her hard work attracts a few admirers, but they don't understand. They can't see the magnificent thing that she has in her mind. And I was just talking to somebody right there who said when she draws, she has this magnificent thing in her mind when she makes a drawing or a painting. And when she tries to get it on paper, sometimes it's not the same thing she has in her mind. She gets mad. So, can you make a little mad face? Like, think about it. Just a little. Like, somebody looking at you would know you were slightly annoyed. Not too mad, okay? The angrier she gets, the faster she works. Okay, can you make your face a little madder? Okay. She smashes pieces in the shape. She jams parts together. She pummels the little bits in, and her hands feel too big to work. Her brain's too full of all the not right things. Now make her face.
man face. I was probably going to be rude. Ooh, that just kind of came out. Yeah. Okay. Ooh. Oh. Okay. Okay, that's enough of that. That's really bad. If the old thing would only just work. Wow. Are there words besides mad for what she's feeling?
Furious.
Let's think for a minute.
Ding.
Okay, I'm going to say 1, 2, 3, and you're going to say all the words for what she's feeling. 1, 2, 3.
Crazy!
Oh, wow, that really didn't work. Because all I heard was a lot of noise. That did not work. So, what was yours?
Curious.
Anybody else have one that they want to put up? Yep.
Frustrated.
Angry. Ooh.
Crazy.
Ooh.
So furious, your head falls off.
Raging.
Raging, yeah.
So mad, people laugh.
Oh, wow, in your head. Yeah, and
outrage.
Outrage. Ooh, I love that. Okay. Then she gets hurt. Can you see what's happening here?
Yeah.
Because she's going too fast and she's pummeling and crunching and crunch. The pain starts in her finger, it rushes to her brain, and she explodes.
Boom.
It is not her finest. I love that part. In your own right now, in your mind, can you just think of a moment that was not your finest moment? When you behaved, just in your mind, just think and put up your finger if you got one. When maybe you were so upset you made some choices that were not your finest moment. That's all you can say. Yep, I think we've all got those times. So, I'm no good at this. I quit. Persistent. She quit.
I thought she exploded.
You know, I think it was a big term of what do you call it?
Figure
of speech.
Yeah.
Oh.
I think it was. Her assistant suggests a walk. It's not much help at first, but before long she starts to feel different. What else could her assistant? Have you ever tried anything besides a walk? Has anybody ever tried something when they were really mad besides a walk?
Nope.
Think anybody? Yeah?
Yeah.
What could you try besides a walk? Yeah. Oh, right here.
Cook.
And
that's what happened.
Sorry, I'm sorry, I don't know your name.
Me?
Yep.
All I do.
Me? Yes. How about in the grace for happiness? Boy, those are good. In the back, you got any ideas for what you could try? What could you do? Yep. Stretching, reading, yep.
Going to the bathroom.
Might help, yep.
I like to bike when I'm mad.
Biking, that's a nice idea. Yep. Has anybody done any breathing? Have you guys done some breathing in here?
No.
Yeah. Thank you. Okay. But before long, she starts to feel different. One thing she's doing is eating. She's having a nice treat. Bit by bit, the mad gets pushed out of her head. As they stroll along, this is the part that really helps. As they stroll along, she comes across the first wrong thing she made. The bad feelings are about to start all over again, but then she notices something surprising. There are some parts of the wrong things that are really quite right. The bolts on one, the shape of another, the wheel to seat ratio of the next, there are all sort of parts that she liked. By the time she reaches the end of the trail, she finally knows how to make the thing magnificent. Wait a minute, how did that happen? Think. First she was mad, then she saw the parts. Can anybody explain what happened? How did she work it out? Yep.
She looked up on the cliff. And say, okay, if I know how to make parts of really good things, I can take them and put them in the place that they're not really good.
Do you know I had to read this book this morning to figure that out? I had forgotten all about that. The afternoon fades into evening. Finally, she finishes. She alerts her assistant. The pair take a good long look. It leans a little to the left. It's a little bit heavier than expected. The color could use a bit of work, too. But it's just what she wanted. They climb aboard and take it for a spin. They're not disappointed. It is really the most magnificent thing.
Yes. It is actually.